Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today we're gonna take a first look at some new video editing software called PowerDirector 18 made by CyberLink. Now, if you're into video editing at all, maybe you have a YouTube channel, maybe you want to create some Facebook videos, video editing software is essential. Now, most operating systems like Windows come with video editing software. For example, in Windows, the Photos app can edit videos. They also have a video editor in there, and it's very basic video editing. But if you want to do anything serious in terms of video, if you want to build up a YouTube channel, if you want to get nice professional looking Facebook videos out, if you want to post videos on Instagram, you really need some more professional video editing software. When I first started on YouTube, I purchased a program called Corel VideoStudio. The reviews were relatively positive. The price point was pretty good at $60, and it was just a one-time payment to pick up that software. So that's where I started on my YouTube channel. And when I first started using the software, it worked okay. But the installation took a long time. Once I started using it, I noticed bugs here and there. The performance was really poor. Whenever I wanted to edit a video, it took a long time. I had to create shadow files. When I went to render the video at the end, I basically had to leave my computer to let it render because it took such a long time. And really the straw that broke the camel's back for me was I recorded a whole bunch of video on my iPhone of my son, and I wanted to edit together a video of that, but Corel VideoStudio couldn't work with the highly compressed video files from the iPhone. And so I was really just done. I didn't want to use it anymore, but I was kind of in my groove. I knew how to use it. And that's when CyberLink reached out to me. They saw that I have a YouTube channel and they said, "Hey, Kevin, would you be interested in testing out CyberLink PowerDirector?" And at that point, I was so frustrated with Corel VideoStudio that I was willing to try something else out. And I said, sure. Now, the one problem is anytime you use new video editing software, you have to learn the new controls, you have to learn where things are. So there's a little bit of a learning curve, but the frustration was great enough where I felt like it made sense to invest the time in learning how to use a new video editing software. CyberLink reached out, they gave me the software for free, and probably my last three or four videos now I've created using CyberLink PowerDirector 18, and I've been very pleased with it so far. I'm pretty pleased that I'm gonna continue using this moving forward, and I definitely recommend it. But what I wanna do is I wanna give a quick tutorial of how I use PowerDirector so you could get a good sense for what is the software like, what's good about it, what's not so good about it, so you too can make a choice as to what video editing software works the best for you. All right, well, enough talk, let's jump on the PC and I'll show you firsthand what things look like. So here I am on my desktop. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up PowerDirector. The install itself goes pretty quickly. Here on my taskbar, you see that I have PowerDirector. It also comes with a screen recorder as well. So I have both of those pinned to my taskbar. I'm gonna go ahead and open up the main video editing software. Here within PowerDirector, you'll see a few things that pop up here at the top. You could select the aspect ratio that you want to edit in. Typically, I do 16:9, but what's interesting is they're really going after the vlogging audience and also Facebook and Instagram by introducing the 1:1 format. This is pretty popular on Facebook. They also have 9:16. This is the typical cell phone format when you hold it in the vertical orientation. And then this is kind of the typical video format, 16:9. So that's what I typically use. Within CyberLink, what they've done is you have your full mode, which is kind of the full-blown classic editing where you have the timeline view. That's typically what I use. However, what they've done is they also realize that you're going to have some users of PowerDirector who aren't as advanced or perhaps don't want the same complexity level. And so they have a storyboard mode where you can drop things on the storyboard. You could also very quickly create a slideshow if you have a bunch of photos. That's kind of a nice one, so you don't have to spend a whole bunch of time creating a good outcome. And lastly, there's also an auto mode where you simply pick a style and it'll create a video for you. So especially for kind of the newer user who doesn't want to learn all the complexities of the software, there's an offering here for you. What I'm going to do is I'm going to jump into the full mode because this is what I typically use when I've been using PowerDirector. So this is the main PowerDirector interface, and within here, it's organized very nicely. I'm just gonna run through kind of how the product's organized. So here, you have a few different pivots across the top. There's something called capture. This is if you have a webcam, if you have a microphone hooked up and you wanna capture content, you could do so by clicking here. I'll click into that so you could see what it looks like. The way CyberLink orders these pivots is it's based on the workflow. You typically start with capturing, then you go on to editing, then you're gonna output your video, maybe you create a disc at the end. Now I'm gonna jump onto the editing tab. This is where you're gonna tend to spend most of your time. This is where you apply transitions, where you apply different effects, where you see all your media content. So this is where the bulk of the time goes. Once you finish editing a video, you'll go ahead and produce it, output it, and then perhaps create a DVD at the end. Although I haven't done that as much. When I create content for YouTube, I typically go to produce. What I want to do is I'm going to load up a sample video just so you can get a sense too for how the main screen is organized. So I'm going to go ahead and open a project that I recently worked on. This was one where I created a video on upgrading to Windows 10 for free. If that's something, if you're on an older version of Windows, you can upgrade to Windows 10 for free. Check out my videos and you can see how to do that. So anyway, what I've done is I've just imported a project, and this is typically kind of how it's going to be set up. You have media content here within the first tab. So this is where you see all your files, your audio, your video files will all show up within here. Any photos, all of that will appear here. On the right hand side, this is where you can view the video that you've pulled together. So here I could see the video that I've put together. And then when I scroll, when I look at the bottom here, this is the timeline view of my video. So I could see my video clip. So here, if I go through the video here, you could see I start out talking a little bit, then I switch to a screen recording, and then I finish off talking again at the end. But I could see on the timeline how it's organized, and I can drag and drop things around. What's nice in here too is I can have multiple tracks. So here as I look down, you could have a second overlay track. If I right click, I could also add even more tracks. So any number of tracks that I wanna add on there, I typically find that 3 to 4 is more than enough, but you could add more than that if you want. So that's kind of the main interface here and how it's organized. I'm gonna walk through on the left-hand side what some of the functionality is. So within a video there, you could apply different effects. There are different plugin packs like Adoraj. There's also, I believe that's how you pronounce it, or Doraj. You also have ProDad, Boris FX. So these are different effect plugins, and they have a lot more effects within them. And then you also have kind of the inbuilt plugins offered by PowerDirector. But there are quite a few in here. They also have video overlays. This is kind of nice if you want to insert shapes, if you want to insert different objects, you could very easily do that from here. What I like about this too is you could also create your own shape. So here I could click in, here I could import an image, but here I could create a new shape. And what's nice about this is, you know, I could create a box, or I could create, so what I could do is I could create a rectangle, a circle, I could apply different presets, and then I have a lot of control over things like opacity, blur, the color, the outline. So not lots of control over creating different shapes within here. I could also draw new items. So kind of lots of flexibility within this view. There's also a particle room where you can have these different 3D overlays on top of your videos. They have premium effects. They also have free templates that you can download. There are lots of free templates that they have on their website, so you can get lots more content. As I go down, you could insert text. They have all these different text overlays that you could do. Some of them are animated, some of them are still. You could do scrolling, you could do 3D or sporty ones. Here's a sporty one, which is kind of neat. But these nice little text overlays, which look very professional and very similar to what you would find on, say, a professional TV production. You also have a massive number of transitions that you could apply to your videos. It's a pretty massive collection here. There's also an audio mixing room where you could set your audio levels with your voice and your music. You could also record a voiceover if you want as you're playing your video. And then lastly, you could also apply chapters. This is mostly relevant if you're going to create a DVD where you want different chapters that users can navigate through. And then the last thing is you could also apply subtitles to your video. So that's kind of the main interface. It's all organized in a very logical, clean way, and I really like the way they've organized this. Now, I want to show some of the things I typically do for creating my videos, and something that I found very valuable. So within here, what I tend to do a lot is I'll create multicam videos. So here I can go in and I could click on edit in multicam designer. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And what that allows me to do is, so I have a video that's synchronized with my screen capture. And what I can do is, let me also bring in my audio. So I'm going to bring in the audio track that goes along with this. And what I can do then is I could synchronize. So I'm going to synchronize this based on the audio and all the files, and that'll just go through, analyze the audio, and then it aligns it all. And what I can do then is I'll produce as a single video, and I could basically play this video clip, and I could click back and forth between 1 and 2 and basically switch the camera back and forth very easily. So this is especially helpful when I'm producing my videos. I find that very, very valuable. Some of the other things that I like too that you could do is here, if I right click on a video clip, or actually if I right click on it up above, I could go to something called pre-cut. And within here, what I could do is I could pre-cut the video. So here, maybe I want to start here and then I'll move on a little bit. So I'll start with this section and maybe I want to keep it up to here. And so I'll stop that. And then I want to maybe keep this portion here. So this is very nice if you have a longer video clip and you just want to keep portions of it. You could very quickly cut those and then bring it into the main editor and just pick the pieces you want or the segments that you want. So that's very nice. In terms of basic editing on the timeline, you could also trim here. If I click on the end, you'll see this little trim tool. So I could trim the clip shorter, I could bring it longer, or I could extend it. Also, if I want to move clips around on the timeline, I simply drag and drop. Here, what's nice is you see this little indicator appearing there, basically snapping it into position. So it's very easy to move your clips forward, move your clips back, trim, and then also pre-cut them. The last thing that I also want to call out, so here if I click on one of these clips, what I can do here too is there's lots of control. I could add keyframes, so I could set the position. So if I jump into the video here, I could say, well, I want the position to be that, versus if I'm here, I want the position to be there. I could adjust the zoom and the size depending on my keyframes at these different points. And there's all types of controls that you could apply, shadow, reflection, you could flip it. So it's very, very powerful software. Even when I click into one of these, there's a fix enhance capability here, which I thought was very interesting. But here, if your lighting's a little off or the white balance isn't quite right, or you want to stabilize the video, or even if you want to apply different LUTs to the video, here, if I'll just click on that as an example, you could apply all of these to the video clip very, very quickly. One thing I also want to call out within the tools menu here, they have all these things where you could adjust the speed of the video, the crop, the zoom. You could also do motion tracking. So let's say you want to blur a face or a license plate. You could very easily do that with motion tracking. One thing that I absolutely love about PowerDirector is the performance. When I load 4K video in, it simply plays the video immediately. I don't have to create shadow files. I have a decent computer, but it just handles the video files very, very well, especially when I compare it to my experience with Corel VideoStudio. And then when you produce video and you export it, goes very fast. So it leverages the graphics card if you want to use that for additional performance. But the experience, what I did in the past with Corel VideoStudio, I'd have to leave the room for 30 minutes as it rendered. Now I render a video and it's just a matter of maybe a few minutes, and a long, say a 10, 15 minute video is done very quickly. To buy PowerDirector, there are a few different options. You could get a lifetime license, which is a one-time fee, and then you get the rights to this version of PowerDirector. So for PowerDirector 18, they have Ultra for about $100, and then there's Ultimate for about $130. Now this is a one-time fee. You don't get access to any of the services, so you don't get additional premium plugins, you don't get unlimited access to background music, it's not always up to date with the latest features, you don't get customer support. So those are a few of the things that you don't get. However, you do get a lot of the essentials. You get the video editing, you get shape designer, you get all these different things, and you get access to some packs and whatnot, but it's just a one-time fee. Now, what CyberLink PowerDirector also offers is what's called their 365 plan, and this is a subscription plan. You could sign up for an annual basis or a monthly plan. And what you do is you get access to all these different premium plugins, you get lots of music, sound clips, you get constant updates, so it's a service. You also get kind of the core editing functionality. You get a lot of cloud storage as well, so either 50 gigabytes or 100 gigabytes. And then you get access, unlimited use of all these different plugins, audio tracks, and effect packs. So you get a lot of additional stuff thrown in there. Lots of different providers are going in this direction where you get a subscription instead and you get all this ongoing value. So you needed to decide if you like PowerDirector. Is it better just buying a one-time license, or is it worth getting a subscription? All right, well, that's a quick look at CyberLink PowerDirector 18. This is the latest version of their software. Like I said at the beginning, I've been using this as my primary video editing software, and I've been very pleased. I like it a lot. I think if you're looking for video editing software, let's say you're doing YouTube or Facebook or Instagram or wherever you want to post videos, this is very solid video editing software, and I think by getting it, you're making a good choice. Although I haven't tried that many different video editing softwares, I'm very pleased with this. The performance is very good. It offers all the fundamental tools. It has multi-cam, it has audio editing tools. There's so much value that you get for either $130 or if you decide to go with a subscription. I think either option is not a bad path. If you're not sure how committed you are to video, perhaps pay the one-time fee. If you know this is something you're gonna be doing for a while, I'm pretty committed to my YouTube channel, so I'd probably consider the subscription just to ensure that I always have the latest great and greatest version of their software. Anyway, if this video helped you make a decision on CyberLink PowerDirector and you decided that this could be good video editing software for you, please give this video a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, hit that subscribe button. That way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. And lastly, if you want to see me cover any other topics on this channel, leave a comment down below. I read them all and I'll add it to my list of videos created in the future. All right, well, that's all I had for you today. I'll see you next time. Bye.